This is okay, but what if we could make it faster and better? As developers, we constantly try to improve our applications so that they are faster, better, and accomplish tasks quickly. But hey, did you know that some of the features in IntelliJ IDEA include the term quickly? And does that mean they enable you to complete tasks in a shorter time? Or do they offer other benefits? Let's find out in this video. In this video, I'll cover four features. Quick lists, quick switch scheme, I know that's a tongue twister, quick definition, and quick documentation. Imagine you work with a bunch of actions frequently, but you do not have any shortcuts assigned to them. You wanted to, but could not, because most key combinations are taken up by other shortcuts. Don't worry, you can create a quick list with all your favorite actions and assign just one shortcut to this list. Each action in the list will be identified by the number 0 to 9. And let's see all of this in action. To create a new list, access Settings and then look for Quick List under Appearance and Behavior. You can find it here, or you could search for Quick List in the Search tab. Now you can see this option here. Click on the plus sign here, add the display name, say, let me say Live Demo, and a short description to go with it. This is frequently used actions during a live demo. Now let me add the actions. The first that I want to add is toggle Zen mode. I use Zen mode all the time in my demo because it really helps me to declutter my UI. Now the second one that I want to add is quick switch scheme. This also gives me access to a lot of shortcuts. Now I want to add a separator, and the next one that goes is select file in project view. Here it is. Again, a separator, and then I want to add collapse all. I really like to collapse the definition of methods so that I could show definition of just one or two methods. The next one is the opposite, which is expand all. Now let me click on OK. The next step is to assign a shortcut to this quick list. To do that, access Settings and search for key map, and then search for the name of your quick list, which is Live Demo. Right click and add a keyboard shortcut. Now click on OK and let's test whether we are able to access our quick list using the shortcut that we just used. Yes, I can. And I can use the various options which I added to this menu like this. Quick switch scheme. This is one of my favorite features in IntelliJ IDEA, and I use it often. It's a handy predefined list of features that you can use to quickly switch between the various themes in your IDE. You can either use find action to find quick switch scheme, or you could use its shortcut, which is control and backtick, to display this list of options. Let me walk through a few of these options, starting with theme. When I select theme, I can view the current theme which I am using in my IDE. I can highlight other theme and wait for 2-3 seconds and see how it will look in my IDE. Isn't that great? I can also install the themes if I click here, and that will take me to the settings because I don't want to do that now. Let me skip it. Now let me go back to my set of options. Here I can also change the editor color scheme, code style scheme, key map. The current key map that I'm using is Windows. I can change it here as well. The other options are, which comes in really handy, are view mode. So these are the multiple view modes. Compact mode was added in the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA. So if I select zoom, and if I increase the zoom size, it zooms in for both my IDE and the editor. Quick definition lets you view the definition of a type without disrupting your flow. Imagine you're browsing through the code base of your project and you're unsure about the contents of a type. Let's say shopping item in this case. I can use go to declaration to view or to read the contents of class. But in this case, I lose my focus. What was I thinking? So is there another way to browse the content without losing my focus or without going to the other class? Yes, it is. I can use quick definition by using Control Shift and I, and this will display the contents of this file in a pop-up in my editor window. So my cursor remains where it was and I do not lose the focus. This feature is also helpful when you are viewing, let's say, definition of a long method where you cannot view all the code in one go. What happens when you are reading one section of that method and you do not remember or recall where a particular variable was declared or how was it defined? Simple. In this case, again, you can use quick definition, which is Control Shift I, and see that the value variable was defined as a method parameter. And what about this variable? Let's say this was defined as a local variable in this method. As the feature name says, quick definition. The biggest benefit of this feature to me is to be able to quickly view the definition of a file without losing my chain of thoughts or without losing my focus. If you revisit the quick definition feature, you'll notice that it does not show you the documentation for a type, which is the result of the Java doc comments. However, it shows other comments like the single or the multi-line comments. So how can you view the documentation for a type and that too quickly? The answer, of course, as you could guess, is quick documentation. To quickly view the documentation of a method, simply take your cursor to the method name and use the shortcut Control Q. And here you go. You can view the documentation right in your editor without navigating to another source file. And if you forget the shortcut, no problem. You can use Find Action and search for quick documentation. Here you go. In this video, I covered some features that let you accomplish your task in a faster way, or should I say, quickly. If you like the content, do not miss to tell me which one of these is your favorite feature. Thanks for watching.